Welcome back. You're watching Nation Now. Fugitive Nirav Modi's painting collection will be auctioned in Mumbai. 68 paintings will go under the hammer with a physical auction today, followed by an online auction on Wednesday and Thursday. A petition has been filed in the Bombay High Court claiming that out of the 68 paintings, only 19 paintings belong to Nirav Modi and hence the auction is unlawful. The IT department has, however, denied receiving any instructions or notice to hold or postpone the auction. My colleague Santhia Gora tracking this big story for us. So, Santhia, first of all, we would like to understand the process and the procedure that will be followed in auctioning paintings, because it's rare for an auction of this nature to happen, of art per se. Can you tell us what will be the procedure like?
Afrida, right now we are present at the venue where exactly the auction is going to take place. This is a place in Mumbai's Prabhadevi area, the office of the auctioneer firm, Saffron Art Firm. This is that very place where the auction will take place. If we talk about the process, Afrida, the auction will start from today, which is 26th of March, and is going to be and it will be there for 3 days. Today's physical auction day, or on the day one, the auction is going to be physical, and on the other 2 days, which is 27th and 28th, the auction is going to be online. Today, the registration will start at 6:30 in the evening, and the auction will start at 7:30 in the evening. Now, if we talk about how the people can participate in it, they can. It's for the physical verification. They can walk in, get themselves registered. The existing clients of the firm do not have to register again. And now, how the payment will be made? Exactly like any other auction, the highest bidder will be the successful bidder. And once the successful bidder makes the highest bidding in the auction, within 4 days of making the bidding, he or she has to make a payment of 10% to the auctioneering firm here. And after 30 days, the highest bidder has to make the remaining payment of 90%. If in case the highest bidder fails to make the remaining payment of 90% within 30 days, the 10% amount which the person paid in the beginning will be automatically forfeited. So this is exactly how, that's the process, Afrida. Okay. That's how the auction is going to take place here.
Yes, like I said, there's been auctioning of property or luxury items, but auctioning of paintings is something new that we will witness. However, Santhia, we also hear that Nirav Modi's lawyer has already come up with an appeal at the Bombay High Court saying not all these paintings belong to Nirav Modi. Can you tell us about specifically about the ownership and what is the claims that are being made from Nirav Modi's side?
Afrida, this petition was filed in Bombay High Court by Camelot firm, which is actually a shell company, which is actually a firm of Nirav Modi. That's what IT department is saying, that the firm actually belongs to Nirav Modi. But if we talk about the claim which the firm has made, they have approached Bombay High Court and have said that out of those 68 paintings which are going to be auctioned by IT department today, only 19 paintings belong to Nirav Modi and Camelot firm. Remaining paintings are not of the firm or of Nirav Modi. That's why the auction should be declared unlawful and illegal. To that, Bombay High Court has kept the matter on for hearing on 27th of March, which is tomorrow. And till then, there is no instruction from the Government of India or Bombay High Court to IT department to hold or postpone the auction. But if we talk about the firm, the company which has taken an objection to the auction, also sent a notice to the Revenue Department saying the same thing. But of course, Revenue Department is not duty bound to postpone or hold the election, hold the auction only on the basis of that notice sent by a private firm. So all they have to do is to wait for any instructions, if it ever comes from Bombay High Court or Government of India for that.
All right. As of now, the IT department has received no such information to hold the auction. So in that sense, the auction will go ahead as per schedule. Thanks, Santhia, for joining us. We'll keep a close tab of all the latest on that front.